Forsooth, comely lass, passest thou me yon knife that I might slaughter this pig for its heinous crimes against non-baconness?
Yea, I pass thee the knife.
Shut up and pass it! Slaughter it! Yea, verily, yon pig is dead.
Please, master, I beg of thee, to end thine own heinous crime of thine own factory, to deny thine own self, that thou mayest not kill any more beasts this year.
Sayest thou that I should deny my love of pork, that I should deny my love of ribs, that I shall deny my love of bacon and of pork chops, and of ham, and of chicken cordon bleu, which are chicken with ham. Yea, verily, thou shalt ask me what is this pig. Cut me open, and take my heart, my very beating heart, from my chest, and cast it away. Nay, I say thee, nay, it shall not be.
For this night, if thou shalt not take upon my words, if in thine own heart, and betray thine own self, I shall take thine own knife, and thou shalt sleep, and I will sneak into thine own chamber, and I will slaughter thine own life, that thou mayest lie upon the floor, and let the pigs eat upon thine own flesh.
Sayest thou this, that thou shalt creep into mine bedchamber at night, and stabbeth me with mine own knife in yon night, and killeth me? My fair lady, I wanteth my key back.
For thine own key lieth no longer in mine own possession. For thine own key is lost. It's lost upon the mountain of which I tried.
Why can't thou not keep up with anything? Thou wouldst lose thine own head were it not screwed onto yon shoulder.
Thou attackest mine own beast. Now thou attackest thine own maid.
Aye, its head is no longer upon its shoulders either.
For thy words pierce mine own heart, and I can no longer gaze upon thine own face, which I once found beautiful.
So be it, lady. For I have loved ye, maid, yea, these many long years, but not so much as I love bacon.